Our today's crime story is from United States of America. It is the crime story of the worst American serial killer. The American serial killer and rapist targeted uncountable innocent young girls from different states of America. The American agencies investigated him for more than 48 hours of interviews, but could find the ultimate number of victims of the deadliest serial rapist and serial killer. His name is Israel Keyes. From the childhood, he was prevailing in a racist atmosphere. During his childhood, he never attended a formal school. He used to attend a church, the Ark, a Christian identity church, which is known for racist and anti-Semitic views. He had also served the American Army for a long period of time. From the Army he had been discharged. Israel Keyes was childhood friends of Chevy and Cheyenne Kehoe, known racists who were later convicted of murder and attempted murder. Israel Keyes' life of crime had started many years before he joined the military service. During his interrogation, he admitted to raping a young girl in Oregon when he would have been 20 years old. He told that he separated a girl from her friends and raped, but not killed her. After discharged from the military, Keyes set up a construction company in Alaska and started working as construction constructor. He expanded his company to almost every region of the United States. He used to traveled many times looking for soft targets and setting up buried caches of money, weapons, and tools needed to kill and dispose of the bodies. To fulfill the construction and traveling expenses, Israel Keyes was collecting money from murders, bank robberies, and other illegal means. It not confirmed that how many banks Keyes had robbed, same the number of murders. He had confessed of killing about 12 young girls, but the exact figure is many times more. The serial killer's spree continued about 11 years. According to his confession, he would fly to some area of the county, then rent a vehicle and then drive it away in search of victim. He would set up and bury murder kits somewhere in the targeted area, stashing items like shovels, plastic bags, money, weapons, ammunition and bottles of Drano, to help dispose of the bodies. His murders kits have been found in Alaska and New York, but he admitted to having others in Washington, Wyoming, Texas and possibly Arizona. He would look for victims in remote areas like parks, campgrounds, walking trails, or boating areas. If he was targeting a home, he looked for a house with an attached garage, no car in the driveway, no children or dogs, he told investigators. Finally, after committing the murder, he would leave the geographic area immediately. In February 2012, Israel Keyes broke his rules and made two mistakes. First, he kidnapped and killed someone in his hometown, which he had never done before. Secondly, he let his rental car be photographed by an ATM camera while using a victim's debit card. In February 2012, Israel Keyes kidnapped 18-year-old Samantha Koenig, who was working as a barista at one of the many coffee stands around Anchorage. Koenig's abduction was caught on video, and a massive search for her was conducted by authorities, friends, and family for weeks, but she was killed shortly after she was abducted. He took her to a shed at his Anchorage home, sexually assaulted her and strangled her to death. He then immediately left the area and went on a two-week cruise, leaving her body in the shed. About a month later, Keyes used Koenig's debit card to get money from an ATM in Texas. The camera in the ATM captured a picture of the rental car Keyes was driving, linking him to the card and the murder. He was arrested in Lufkin, Texas on March 16, same year. On December 2, 2012, Israel Keyes was found dead in his Anchorage jail cell. He had cut his wrists and strangled himself with a rolled-up bedsheet. Under his body was a blood-soaked, four-page letter written on yellow legal pad paper in both pencil and ink. Investigators could not make out the writing on Keyes' suicide note until the letter was enhanced at the FBI lab. An analysis of the enhanced letter concluded that it contained no evidence or clues, but was merely a creepy ode to murder, written by a serial killer who loved to kill. Kindly don't forget to subscribe our channel for more crime investigation reports. Thank you.